I continue with my series of tribute videos to my former players from Chiparamba. I once posted a video about Davidson Kausu on my YouTube channel. This one is going to replace that because I don't feel that the first one I did justice to Davy. See, all the players in the national team, the Zambia national team, the famous 2012 AFCON winning team, took different pathways to get to the national team. Davidson Kausu was no different. Davy, we discovered Davy, Chiparamba discovered Davy from a small team in his home compound of Kanyama. That team was called Kanyama Lions and they played Barcelona type football. They were a beautiful young team that played great football. The team was owned and coached by the late Mr. Zimba, may his soul rest in peace. What a lovely man who was so dedicated and committed to football in Kanyama. Davy joined Chiparamba and we traveled with him to Europe. He played for Chiparamba in the Lusaka Under 17 League and the Lusaka Amateur League. He won a Dana Cup and got to the semi-final of the Gothia Cup. We were able during our World AIDS Day tournament in 2002 to get the scout for Africa, the late Frank Lord, who was based in Cape Town as the Man United scout for Africa. He came down and watched our tournament. And at the tournament, he chose Davidson Kausu and Dominic Yobe from the team, the Chiparamba team that won the World AIDS Day tournament that year. I was fortunate enough a few months later to travel with Davy and Dominic to Manchester. The boys were there for 2 weeks. I spent the first week with them. The boys met Alex Ferguson, Roy Keane, Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, David Beckham. And the week I was there, I observed the boys. I observed them in the cafeteria. I observed them on training. I observed them around the Carrington. Davy never looked intimidated, never looked out of place. He looked at home. Unfortunately, Man United didn't sign him. We had a sister club relationship with a club in the Premier League in Sweden called Ögryte. And Ögryte then invited Davy to come and spend a few weeks there. Again, good experience for him. You see, it was our belief at Chiparamba that what we needed to do was give our young Zambian boys the exposure to football at the highest level. Them getting signed was always the goal and a bonus, but the main thing was to open their minds, to get them to dream bigger, to be more ambitious and more knowledgeable about the game. So Davy's time in Manchester and Davy's time in Sweden certainly opened up his mind and made him want more from his football. Through our network, we were able to get Davy a contract in the academy at Tux, University of Pretoria. He joined the academy, he finished his education, got his grade 12 or matric as they call it in South Africa at Tux. Played academy football. They then got promoted to the National First Division, where Davy played. From Tux National First Division side, he was signed by SuperSport United, where he experienced PSL, Premier Soccer League football, for the first time. And it was from there that Davy made the leap to under 23 and to senior national team. The height of Davis's football career was the pinnacle of the mountain of Zambian football, the 2012 AFCON. Davy didn't start in the first game, but he secured a place from then on, and Coach Hevrena did not drop him after that. I always like to repeat a quote I heard many years ago. Football is a game of moments. There were three moments in the final game against Ivory Coast. Number one, Didier Drogba missed the penalty and goalkeeper Kenneth Dimwene flashed fingers in front of him. I remember that. At the end of the game, in the middle of the celebration, Coach Hevrena lifted injured Joseph Musonda and carried him over to join his teammates in celebration, moment number two. Moment number three, I take you back into the game. Davis is playing on the right side. Zambia is attacking. Coach Hevrena is not happy with the way Davy is marking Jovinho and he screams at him. On the camera, we could see the coach going crazy, screaming at Davy. And Davy patted the coach on the back as if to say, "Coach, don't worry, I've got this. Jovinho is not going past me." The results stand. Jovinho never went past Davy. But that's Davy, you see. You put Davy in the middle of fire. You put Davy under pressure. You put Davy in a corner. He comes out fighting. Davis is a warrior. I have so much respect and so much love for Davis in Kausu. He's the one player in Chiparamba that I have kept in touch with. 1 week doesn't go by when Davy and I don't exchange messages on motivation, on family, on football and jokes. So today my dedication is to my friend, to my young brother, Davis in Kausu.